Why, hello there, YouTube, and welcome to a random review. I am Random Ross, and today I review Star Wars Ahsoka. So, this is created by Dave Fillon, starring Rosario Dawson, Natasha Lou Brosbizo, something. And it also stars Mary Elizabeth Winstead, the late Ray Stevenson, Ivana Sacno, Diana Lee Santo, David Tennant, and many other characters in this. So this is, you know, takes place around the same time as The Mandalorian. It's a spin-off of The Mandalorian. Takes place 10 years after Return of the Jedi, the conclusion of the original trilogy. And in this, Ahsoka Tano reunites with old friends, you know, to, well, stop this evil force which is in the Empire from ever rising again. And we get reintroduced to some characters from the Star Wars Rebel series as well, like Sabine, and also you know, we get some new characters as well in there. So Ahsoka Tano, she was introduced into the Star Wars Clone Wars animated series and became a fan favorite. And they officially made, like, the Clone Wars, the animated show, canon. And, you know, Rosario Dawson plays Ahsoka Tano for the first time in an episode of The Mandalorian Season 2. She then appeared in The Book of Boba Fett as well. And, you know, she's now got her own miniseries where she's, you know, the lead. And I liked her character, Ahsoka. She was the one that kind of made this watchable. We also got David Tennant in it as a droid. He was playing the droid Hygin, who appeared in the, you know, who appeared in the animated series, The Clone Wars, and David Tennant returns for that because he was in that as well. So David Tennant is in that. And we also get Mary Elizabeth Winstead as Hera, who, you know, is a general of the New Republic. And we also get, you know, some other characters in there, like Shin Hati, who is a dark Jedi with her master. Baylan Skoll, who was also a former Jedi that survived the Order of 66 and became a dark Jedi, played of course by the late Ray Stevenson. They were interesting characters too. I also liked that, and you know, their dark characters. And of course we got Hayden Christianson return as Anakin Skywalker as a Force ghost. So of course we've all been, you know, thinking, will Hayden Christensen return to the franchise again as Anakin or Darth Vader? And he did. There was an episode where he trains Ahsoka, where she's deep within, like, her subconscious in the Force as a Force ghost with Anakin, and we see glimpses of him being Darth Vader and that. And we see him again as a Force ghost. We even tap into Ahsoka's memories and see her in the Clone Wars, where she was only a young teenager and Anakin's Padawan. I like that Hayden Christensen actually returned, and that they, I'm assuming, de-aged him and what have you. And yeah, I think the last two episodes were actually good. People say the last two episodes were poor, but I actually think they were good. They say the first six episodes were good. I'm kind of a bit of the other way around. I found the first six episodes a bit slow, which I'll get to now in my dislikes. Yeah. The last two episodes were great. I enjoyed watching them. It actually had my attention, them ones, and I watched them continuously. But the first six episodes, I gotta say, were hard work. Watching it just felt like a chore, and the pacing was slow, and there were moments where I got bored and got out my phone. I don't know. I fear that Disney may be running the Star Wars brand into the ground now. I mean, they clearly thought, okay, movies aren't getting us nowhere, we finished the sequel trilogy, Solo, that spin-off didn't do so good, and, you know, let's just stick to doing Disney Plus shows because the fans like it and what have you. So far, The Mandalorian's been the hugest success, and that's had 3 seasons and I believe a 4th season in the work. And we've had other one-off shows like Obi-Wan Kenobi and The Book of Boba Fett and Andor, which I couldn't get into, and I never even finished that because I was bored with it. And we also have another one coming, Star Wars Skeleton Key or something, with Jude Law. Yeah, I'm kind of glad that that this was a one series thing, as far as I know, and they're not making any more. It was nice to see Ahsoka in her own leading show, but yeah, I also like Mary Elizabeth Winstead's character as well. She was an interesting role, and also Sabine. She was really beautiful, and I love the callbacks we got to, like, you know, the, you know, Star Wars Rebel series, which I did watch a bit of, but I got bored with that halfway through. We also had a few guest roles in this, like Clancy Brown, who's in quite a bit of stuff lately. And we also got a cameo from C-3PO. I don't know if it was Anthony Daniels in the suit, but I know that was his voice. And we got to see C-3PO, which I thought was a nice touch. But this series, it was okay, but like I say, it had its pacing issues, for me, in my opinion. That's just my opinion. None of you have to agree with it, but I'm just giving you my honest one. So, my ratings for Ahsoka, I will give it probably, I'm afraid I'm going to have to give this 3.5 out of 5 for this one. 3.5 out of 5 for Ahsoka. So there you go. Have you seen this one? Let me know down in the comments below. If you have, did you like it better than I did? You know, and if you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Feel free to share with your friends and subscribe if you haven't already, and to hit that notification bell. And until next time, I bid you all a goodbye, friends. Goodbye.